Liv, we're glad to be together again. We've been talked about what God fight for us. We looked at main ways of why it's important for us to put on the armor of God, and why it's important for let God fight for us. We are now looking in at the cross now. We've been looking at three ways where God can fight for us. We are looking through with all these things that God has said unto us, and how we stand up on Him and His free will, and how the government mandates it's nothing, but freedom is everything. And the freedom where we are need to focus on is God's freedom. And that's how important it can be in our lives. We also look in God's way, and God's, we look in just only one way, and one gate, and one destiny of all the problems in our world, which is our sins and our, and what Christ can do on the cross for our sins. And that's what we're going to look at now. Let's look at the cross. Take a look with me in Psalm chapter 19, verse 28. See, after this, he says, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, saith, I thirst. Now there was said a vessel full of vigor, and they filled its bonds with vigor, and put it upon Hesed, and put it to his mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vigor, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. They seized silver because it was the preparation of the bodies to not be remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day. For that Sabbath day was on high day, but some pilot, that their legs might be broken, and that they might be taken away. They come, the soldiers, to broke their legs at the first and at the other, which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they broke not his legs, but one of the soldiers, with a spear, pierced his side. And forthwith came there out blood and water. And he that saw it bare record, and his accord is true, and he knoweth that he saith true, that he might believe. But these things were done, that the scripture should be fulfilled, a bone of him shall not be broken. And again, in the other scripture saith, they shall look on him whom they pierced. And after this, so said them among us, being a disciple of Jesus, but secretly for fear of the Jews, brought to Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave him leave. He came therefore and took the body of Jesus, And there came also Nicodemus, which at the first came to Jesus by night, and brought a vessel of myrrh and aloes about 100 pound weight. Let's stop there. You probably say, what that means? It talks about that a boat will be broke of this. And you see, the scriptures need to be fulfilled. But one of the things you need to focus on at the first of the saying that Jesus said, I thirst. What he thirsts about? He gives the vigor to him, right? We saw that his blood is of warning. But he's also said in Psalms 10. It's all 7:10 here. Verse 12 through 18. Which says, but he that is unholy and not the shepherd whose own the sheep are not seeth the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and feareth, and the wolf calleth them and scattereth the sheep and hearing with, because he is unholy and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep. And am known of mine. I am the Father. Knoweth me. Even so, know I the Father, and I lay down my life for my sheep. And after sheep, and other sheep, I have, which are not of the fold, them also I must bring, and they shall bear my voice, and there shall be one fold, and one shepherd. Therefore doth my Father love me, because I lay down my life, that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. In commitment I have received my Father. That's as we talk about that Jesus is willing to give up his life. He's willing to give up his life for us. That's because he wants to shed his own life and his blood to forgive our sins. And that's the next part. Our sins is so nasty that we already deserve death. It only takes 1 minute to take care of that. It says in Romans 6:12-3, for the wages of sin is death, but to the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Our sin is so bad that it takes 1 minute to die for it. How bad it can be for that to happen?
Call from Robert Bessie.
Let me take a look with me to Revelation 3:16. In Revelation 3:16 said, so then, because thou art like warm, never cold hill no hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. He probably says, what that host mean? He post me that Jesus hates it so much, he wants to vomit it out. May no difference what kind of sin it should be, neither is in greater sin for those who are in the hybrid system like your government. If you want to make it great again, you must repent of your sin. Because your sin is so bad, it cannot be taken away from you. But all you have to do is go to the cross, and that cross will give you the light of what God can do for you. And because what he done on the cross, it's so much that he truly loves us. He wants to die for us, although we have sinned against him. Take a look in Psalm 3:16. For God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten Son. And whosoever believeth on him, son of course will have everlasting life. You see, he gives us free will. He really does. He gives us free will to make our minds if we are for him or not for him. But he'd be fully ashamed of us if we sin. But he truly loves us, though. He loves us so much that he tried to draw you back to him by dying for you on the cross. That's how much love can be. If he wanted to die for you, that means it's important for you to love Jesus so much, because what he done for your life is great for anything. That's why you should let God fight for you to take down the sins of this world. You are a sinner as well. Everyone has sins, including my sins. I'm a sinner. You probably think, so that means I can't trust you with this message? Don't trust me with this message, but trust God with this message. That's the idea. Our sin is so bad, knowing I am not wise enough to tell you about my sins. But only God can. But how can we make Mother great again? How can we make our nation great again? Go to the cross. That's where we need to make our nation great again. It's at the cross. Go to the cross. But not just our nation. We need to make the world great again. The whole town world. Not just our nation. Not just make China great again. Not just Russia make again. Not just Ukraine great again, but the whole world needs to fall to the feet and repent of their sins. Because if not, we will face judgment. Just go to the cross. That's all you have to do. Fall to your knees, repent of your sin. That's all you have to do. And when you do that, you have to believe top of your heart that he had died for you. This war is not between us. It's between God and the devil. The only way we have victory, we have that, is for us to obey his commands and fall to our knees to pray to him and let him fight for us. That's how we're able to fight the good fight. By letting him fight for us. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day, Lord. Lord, just help us to make my God great again by trusting you and go to the cross where your blood can help us to understand where what we need to go as, Lord, how our sins needs to fall on you, and how you, and what you done on the cross is for the simple of our sins, and what you done for forgiving of it, Lord. Let our nation know about this, Lord, and let this be, let this video go viral so people will know that they can trust in you, Lord, not on me, but on you, and knowing that your name is great for us. Thank you, Lord, for listening, Lord. Nobody like a lukewarm Christian, and nobody will like a lukewarm participant. Nobody will like a lukewarm American. You're a lukewarm person at all, Lord. Lord, just help us to be the person that you want to, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for staying in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you. Bye.